So the problem with tall cell variant of papillary carcinoma is what exactly is it from a pathology point of view? We know that the tumor cells tend to be large, and various authors and students of thyroid cancer have defined large tumor cells and the number of times length versus width in various ways. And so because you have various definitions, it becomes pretty impossible to get a whole bunch of pathologists, even so-called endocrine pathologists who concentrate on the endocrine system, to agree as to what a tall cell variant is. They tend to be extremely papillary, and because they are so, the papillae fall in upon one another and lead to what I'm going to show you, a train track pattern of growth of this tumor. It is unusual to have tall cell papillary carcinoma show follicular differentiation. The nuclei may be clear or may not be clear, but they have inclusions. They have a lot of inclusions, and in cytologic preparations, you may guess that this might be a tall cell papillary carcinoma by the fact that some of the nuclei have inclusions, and this has been called by some as soap bubble looking cells, and they can have mitotic activity. Now, here are two different cases of tall cell variant papillary carcinoma. On the left, you see some colloid, but you notice that the cells are quite voluminous in their cytoplasm. And on the right, you see the train track growth of the tall cell variant of papillary carcinoma. Notice that the individual cells are rather narrow, but they have a lot of cytoplasm. And most pathologists feel that they should be at least three times as long as it is wide. And here is a beautiful case of tall cell variant papillary carcinoma with an absolutely spectacular and perfect intranuclear inclusion. There are several other inclusions in some of the other cells. Those of you who are pathologists on the line can see them.